Tasma Walton is the West Australian darling who won hearts and a Logie for her gutsy portrayal of Constable Dash McKinley on Blue Heelers. She's been lighting up our screens on City Homicide and even found time to marry the host of some TV show. Now she's a published author with her debut novel Heartless hitting shelves around the country.
I'll be still my beating heart, it's Tasma Walton! Whistling at the woman.
All right.
Woo.
Now, can you believe it's almost 10 years to the day since you were last on this show?
Wow.
So, what have you been doing since then?
Well, I, quite frankly, have been doing you most recently.
Oh! Is that where you want to take this? Is that where you want to take this?
I just thought we'd better get that.
Is that where we're going? Is that where we're going with this?
All right. Excuse me, would you guys like us to leave the studio with this?
Everybody out there.
Everyone and that guy, he can stay.
Obviously, you know, this is obviously a bit weird because
I
have to ask you. But I'm still going to try to be as professional as I can with all this and
do my job
properly. So, Tasma.
Yes.
Would you say you are difficult to live with while you're writing?
Well, what you might not know, Rove, is I start writing when he goes to work. And you might not know my process, which is I switch on a bit of Prince, I strip down to my underwear, and I eat strawberries dipped in chocolate.
I knew it. And Bryce Courtney does the exact same thing.
Just so you know. He was my inspiration for that.
So, now, what was the inspiration for the book? Book's called Heartless.
Yes.
So what's the actual inspiration, then, behind the title and the story?
Well, I've always had this kind of weird fascination with hearts and the way that we sort of turn it into a mystical organ. And I think for a while there I thought I'd be a heart surgeon.
Did you really?
I actually didn't know this. I did.
So we're all learning something. It's great.
But I tell you what put me off that. I did human biology in year 11 and 12.
Yes.
As you would say, human rat round.
That's my fifth grader thing.
I've seen that. Anyway, so we were doing human biology and I was really getting into it and thought, yeah, totally I'm going to be like a heart surgeon and everything, until our teacher brought in these sheep's hearts. You know how you had to do dissecting and stuff? She brought in this sheep's heart, she got the aorta, put it down her finger, and then, like, walked around the classroom with the heart on her finger going like this, making funny noises, and then... There goes my heart surgeon dreams.
Are teachers allowed to do that? You could sue them nowadays. Your character, we follow her in the book every 7 years, starting at 7 years of age.
Yes.
I would actually like to know myself, what were you like at seven?
What was it? I like at seven?
Yeah, yeah. You little shit.
I was a little shit
or something.
I can tell you when I'm like at 7-Eleven, and that is pretty pissed.
And that's what I was like at seven. I was always called a scruff. I was called Butch. I was a scruff, a tomboy. I used to make mud pies. I used to do this really cool thing that I thought was really cool. I used to have matchy cars. Anyone else like matchy cars? You know, the matchbox cars. Anyway, I used to time myself on a daily basis to see if I could do around the house in 80 minutes with my matchbox car. So you're not allowed to touch the floor, so you've got to do it on walls and furniture and stuff like that. I used to see if I could beat my record.
Can we do that at home?
We would be there for like ages.
Now I'm going like this stuff. Like they give me, oh look, here's all questions to ask. And I know I really don't need these. I'm going to rip them up. And also too, because what happens is, you know, I can't.
He's so strong.
I meant that to happen. Because okay, we have guest producers on the show, and they sit down with a guest beforehand and say, and then this is the plan for the show. And then you told me when you were having the call with our guest producer, I had to leave the room.
Yes.
What's going on? Is there something?
Nothing.
Is there something I need to know?
I think you should just go with your questions, actually.
Well, I have been told that I need to ask you something about birds because I like birds.
No.
Yes,
you like
I
birds?
Do. I'm a bird fan. we have a cat in the house, which I didn't like cats before, and now I like cats. And I've made you like birds, haven't I?
You have, you have.
So what? So what of it?
I just wanted to say, because I really thank you from the bottom of my heart for showing me the wondrous world of birds. And in fact, the first time that I really clicked with birds, you showed me Sir David Attenborough's Birds in Paradise special.
Yes.
Now, I know that he's your celebrity free pass, if you would like to. I know, that's okay.
Yes.
But anyway, there was this one little guy, this one little bird, that I just fell absolutely in love with. And I can't work out whether it's just because he's totally damn cute or whether he reminds me a little bit of you. And we have some footage, right? Can we show the footage of him cleaning out his bike, right? So Rove's a neat freak. Rove's a neat freak, and that's what he totally looks like when he's
that
cleaning out
the house. That is a plumed bird of paradise.
Yes.
Are you? No, no, no.
But the thing that really made me fall in love with him is the little kind of entertainment dance display thing that he does for the ladies. Let's have a little look at how he goes. Check it out. And see what the girls, all the girls come down. He really turns it on. And then just wait for this bit. This is the big finish. Sights himself up and... Let me go! How could you not fall in love with something like that when something like that does something like that, right? And what everybody here in the audience...
No!
..and at home might not know is that Rove himself does a very fine display.
This is private at-home stuff.
Which you will now show for everybody and...
I don't even know what you're chanting.
Are you going to do it? Are you going to do it without the jacket?
I can do it without the jacket. No, I can't. I'm microphone
down. Oh, damn.
Okay. This is our... Okay.
Our thing.
I have been known to present at home. Okay.
With this man.
Oh, you. Wow, one person applauded that. That's good. Tasma Walton, are you ready for your public probe?
I'm a bit scared now. Oh, I'm scared.
Well, I have to. It's too easy for you to publicly probe your wife. So what I would like to do is publicly probe both of you at the same time.
Oh! Yeah.
That's all right. Ooh. So bring out a seat. Yes, go.
Oh, it might be.
We're doing it properly.
Really?
Yeah, this is my chance. Here we go. Here we go.
Okay. We'll have to try this one early.
Uh-oh.